So let's give our shoulders a roll. And if you bring them up to your ears, squeeze and press down. And then we're going to alternate right and left. And I'm going to turn that roll of the shoulder into a roll of the arm. And I want you to turn your head, turn your upper body, but keep your lower half facing front. So it's warming up more around your torso and the muscles which rotate your spine. And I want you to bring your knee up and tap back, knee up and tap front. So up, tap back, up, tap front. And change to the other side, knee up, tap back, up, tap front. Alrighty, we're going to come up onto our tiptoes and then we're going to fold the body down to touch the toes. I'm curling and coming up to tiptoes and steady the balance. Can you turn your eyes up, test your balance, and then looking down to touch the toes. Breathing in, coming up, reach up. And exhale as you drop. And curling, breathing in, tiptoes, eye gaze up, exhale and drop. Uncurling, and do it again. Can you go down a little bit further now? Maybe even get hold of your ankles and a gentle pull of the upper body towards the legs. We're going to do that twice more. And last one. And opening the feet. So you've got a bit of width between the feet, soft in the knees, sliding one hand down the side of the knee. And come back up. Reaching the hand down the leg, bringing the other one up over the top. And with each one, aiming that arm more horizontally. Breathing in. And breathing out. Going a little bit further. And then adding a sweep round, straight legs and a flat back. There, one more on each side. And last one. And if you can bring your legs back in, we're going to come down onto the mat, have a little drink if you need one. Okay, so some knee tucks. If you can bring your knees up and then tap down, you're going to tuck, tap, try and get your bottom off the floor. And point your toes, breathe out as you tuck, in as you release, either staying with this version with the head on the floor or adding a rise, balance, and then roll. More advanced, we add some reach. And we do that one more time. And then let's focus on warming up our back muscles. So if we can come over onto our front, hands just slightly wider than our shoulders. We're going to press the shoulder blades down as we lift, point the toes, chin up, and then lower the body back down. And let's do that again. So notice how your back's feeling. Squeeze your bottom to give your back support as you lift. And then lower. And as you do it, if your back's feeling happy and strong, we add a bit more height. Just tuning into what's needed in your back today. Pointing the toes. And then relaxing the toes as you come down. Do that three more times, holding at the top for three. One, and then lower. So again, three, one, and then lower. And final one. And then releasing. And let's come up and find our downward dog. So if we can push the tailbone up in the air. Deep breath as we hold. Pressing down with the heels. The heels are nearly on the floor. Just walk your feet a bit further back to get a little bit of a gap underneath them. So we get that good stretch in the calves. We're going to pump the feet, so we press down through one side, flexing the toes on the other side, and then switch. On the side where the toes are bent, applying a little bit of pressure under the toes to mobilize the feet. To lose a little bit of blood flow through the feet in this kind of weather, so good to get the circulation going there. Do one more on each side. And then if we take a walk with the feet towards the hands and come down onto our backs, let's focus on doing some core work. Okay, so if you can take your opposite arm away from your leg and then back in. And pull the belly button muscle in as you tap down. Level two, we'll bring the knees up like this. Starting with the knee above the hip. We're going to continue pointing the toes and then flexing the feet. Or level three, we'll do it here with straight legs. Can we do that twice more? So last one. And then we're going to bend the knees like this with the hands here on the top. I'm going to circle out, round, and back in. And then reversing back in the opposite direction. Decided to put my waterproof trousers on for the school run this morning. Slightly restrictive in the movement, but nice and toasty. All right, so last one. And then from here, we're going to come up to seated with a crisscross leg. So we park ourselves up on the sitting bones. And we can do these either cross leg or feet wide. And we're going to come up. Reach up to the ceiling, and then as we come down, we'll go quite wide with the hands, chin to chest. Sliding the hands in, coming up, reaching towards the ceiling, arms back by the ears, and then coming down and forwards, two, three, and back in with the arms. And let's do that again with each one, just noticing where you get to. Then is it doable just to nudge a centimetre or inch forwards, back in. Switch the legs. Working on that reach. final one. Sliding hands back in. Can we find a stick as we come up to standing? We're going to work on some lunges to open our hips, work on some stamina building in our legs. And we'll use the stick to monitor our posture. We want the head, shoulders, and tailbone against the stick, and then a big stride between the feet, tucking the tailbone under as we drop. We'll come down, 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 and then lift, straightening the front leg. Now as we come down, can we keep the knuckles and lower back sandwiched together? Breathing in as we lift, and breathing out as we lower. Keep squared up in the hips. And let's do that one more time. Can we hold this last one for longer? Aiming to lean back, pushing the back of the head against the stick. Straightening out through the back leg. And then from here, we're going to come up, but just slightly slide the back foot in so it's more at the edge of the mat. And then the front one also at the opposite edge of the mat. So use your mat to gauge where your feet go. Particularly on your back foot, that heel may sort of sink inwards. Try and line the edge of your foot up so it's parallel or thereabouts with the mat. And then release this front hand, the same hand as the thigh, and apply just a gentle pressure mid-thigh. We want to get the hips squared up. Often the back leg hip will sit backwards. Can you nudge that forwards and notice the difference that makes? Lean to a sort of flat back shape, keeping the tailbone on the stick. Tailbone tucks will lose the effectiveness of the stretch. Try and keep the tailbone and the stick together. Breathe. Alrighty, let's release. And we're going to turn and move in back into our lunges. So wriggling the back foot away. So we're on tiptoes now on that back foot. And we want, again, the knuckles and the lower back sandwiched together as we come down, down, down. Breathing in as we lift, and breathing out as we lower, all the way down, keeping the hip bones squared up. And let's do that again. Straighten out through the back leg. And on this final one, we're going to come down and hold it. Let's see if we can hold it for about 15 seconds. Breathe. Keep squaring up the hips, straightening out the back leg. Alrighty, and then we're going to move into our yoga hamstring stretch. So again, we'll get the edges of the feet parallel with the mat, side of the mat, and then leaning into it with front hand just resting on our mid thigh. Now just checking in on the hips. Can you align them so that back leg hip isn't wandering off somewhere? Just nudging it forwards and just checking in with the tailbone. Now we got the tailbone and the stick together. Breathe. And then from here, we're going to soften into the knee, and we're going to switch the hand behind and hover single leg. So we want the leg up behind, and we should go into a forward lean posture. We can get some height on the leg. Transition to the other leg. So training and testing our balance on these. And when you come down, can you get your body upright again? So use your screen. Does your torso look upright as the leg lifts? And then use the leg to lever you forward. Holding, breathe. And then coming down. Control. Okay. As we do the other side, we're going to bring our opposite arm forwards. We get some height on that arm. The arm comes up by the ear, pointing through the toes. And transitioning to the other side. So can we stay upright as we extend the leg back and lift the leg? Adding some lean, reaching forward with the arm, breathe. And transitioning one more time each way. Can we get more height as we go through each one? Reaching the fingers, reaching the toes, using the eyes to steady the mind. And last one, welcoming the wobble. Alrighty, let's rest off. Now's a good time to top up on water. Have we got some weights there? We'll give our legs a rest and we're going to work on our arms and upper body. So if you can have your weights in your hands, make sure they feel slightly heavy so that you're getting some conditioning. And we're going to move out to the side and then come back in. So for first level, squeezing the shoulders, trying to keep the hand flush with the forearm, and back in. Concentrate on that squeeze in the shoulder, and then extending, and coming back in. With the extension, we'll add a rise onto the tiptoes, for level two, and then back in and down. For level three, we'll add arms raising up, the shoulder blades soften down and to the middle. Think about your posture as you do it. Allow your tailbone to sort of hang down rather than the back being an overarch. That way we keep pressure out of the lower back joints as we start to lift slightly heavier weights. Keep that progression happening. We're loading our muscles, loading our bone density over time. Do that twice more. Alrighty, so last one. Should be getting tough by the 10th one. Alrighty, well done. Resting off. We're going to come back to our stick again. We're going to do some sticky squats. So we'll use the stick along the back to monitor our posture in the squat. We want it attached to the head, the shoulders, the tailbone. And we're going to pull the lower back to the knuckles before we start. Now, can you keep your knuckles and lower back attached as you sit down? Your squat, keeping the tailbone there but the lower back long, and then coming back up. So our first level today, I'm gonna keep going with the stick, tuning into the posture, pressing the knees out. A level two, much more of a balance challenge. Feels unsafe to do it with the roll and stick with the stick. So level twos, so we're going to use the stick here in front to steady ourselves on the foam roller. Quite good for ski training, actually. Give the boys a couple of dry slope lessons. They seem to get on well with it. Bertie does feel the cold, bless him. And then for third level, stay down for a little bit longer, more advanced. Take the stick away. Alrighty, let's do two more. Staying down there, holding three, two, one. Release. The last one. Alrighty, resting off. Now's a good time to grab a drink. Keep hold of our stick as we come down and do some oysters, working on the muscles around the side of the hip, bones in the hip, helping our bigger picture of our bone density. So head, shoulders, tailbone against the stick, knees up in front there. We're going to work on the lift in the waistline, pointing the toes, rolling the knee back. Squeeze the buttock muscle, flex the feet down. So we're going to keep the top leg hovered throughout the move. Squeeze and then flex, hovered leg. Next up, I'm going to add some reach through the toes, control on the way down. Then we bend, point the toes as we open, reach up to the ceiling, coming back down. Next level, we do it up in a side plank position. Choose your level, keep going with it. Use the stick to monitor your posture. So head, shoulders, tailbone, laying against it. Just gonna do that a couple more times through. The last one. Alrighty, let's give that a go on the other side. So aim to get the knees in front of the hips there. And we'll work on the lift in the waistline. Pointing the toes as we roll the knee back. Now the key is not to let the top hip wander. We'll get more muscular activation where we want it. We can keep the hips stacked. Pointing the toes, flexing. Two, we add that reach. So working on our mobility around our hip, strength in that area. Third level, adding in that extra layer with the side plank. Alrighty, so last couple. And final one. Okay, good job. We're going to roll over to our back and give our glutes a stretch, particularly where we've just been working. So if we park the right leg over the left, like this, and pop the hands around the back of the thigh, use the hands to pull in, use the elbow to push out, breathe. If you can get the hands around the back of the thigh, that's it. See if we can get that ankle bone just on top of the knee there. Sit down. And Let's give that a go on the other side. Left over right. The hands just at the back of the thigh. Moving the elbow to push the knee out. Get that ankle bone down the thigh. Alrighty, let's release. So we're going to move up to a seated position. We're going to pop the hands just here behind. We've got the fingertips pointing forwards. We'll do some work for our arms and our upper body. So a few levels to choose from again. First level, we're going to straighten out. Oh, bless you, Anne. Got the sneezes. So we're going to straighten the arms and lift the chest. So first level, just sort of using the force of the ground for a strengthening effect. And then bending the elbows, elbows pointing backwards, and then straightening again, pushing the ground away and lifting the chest. So the bottom stays on the floor for our first level. Next level, we add more lift through the bottom, aiming the knees, the chest, and the hip in line. And then lowering. Breathing in on the lift, squeezing the knees slightly, and breathing out on the lower. The third level, go straighter legs, pointing the toes, adding more length into the leg. I'm going to do a couple more. It can get quite tough through the arms, through the shoulders. So last one, and then we're going to give our chest a good old stretch. Alrighty, so resting off, you can give your arms a bit of a shake out. So let's come up to standing. Now's a good time for some water. And we're going to need a little bit of wall space. Stretching our pecs, we're going to twizzle our fingers backwards. And we want this arm on the wall behind us. So if you stride your inside leg forward and bend into your front knee, we're going to turn and look behind. Breathe deeply. Then if you wriggle your fingers a little bit higher up, bend into your front knee, lift your head, breathing deeply. And then can you go a little bit higher up with your arm? Bend into it, just where you feel the stretch. Breathing into it. Just iron out stiffness around the pecs, helps us with the rounded shoulders. So let's do that on the other side. The fingers twizzle backwards, striding forward with the inside leg and applying that little bit of pressure. Palm into the wall, we turn. The upper body in towards the middle of the room. Deep breath. And let's move the fingers a little higher up. Bending the knee. Turn the upper body. Alrighty, so let's go a little bit higher up. Bend into the front knee, turning the head. Breathe. Alrighty, let's release. Okay, so we're going to come down onto a seated position. And I'd like to find a weight. I think a weight Where's my weights gone? Oh, there they are. Okay, so seated with your feet flat on the floor like this. And I want you to lengthen up through your body. So you elongate up through your torso. You're going to bring your weight up over the top of your head and then tap it down. Coming up and then tap down. And I want you to follow it with your eyes. So you're going to look slightly behind you. Come up, eye gaze to the ceiling, and then look down. But level one, we'll do it with our feet on the floor. Level two, we'll do it with a single leg hover, and then alternate to the other leg. But level three, we're going to lift both the legs, making sure we've got a happy back, doing that tougher version. Last couple. My final one. Okay, and then from here, we can put you down on your back with your right knee hugged in. I'm gonna bring the knee across the body, bringing the foot to the floor, knee down, trail the other arm behind. Eye gaze looking towards our back arm. Pressing the shoulder down, breathing deeply. Alrighty, and then if we can bring our knee up to our chest, foot towards the floor, trail the other arm behind, applying a bit of pressure with that knee towards the ground, pressing the back shoulder down, breathing into the stretch, breathing into the belly. Let's roll over onto our front. We're going to stretch our quads. So if you grab a strap, if you need one, and we'll get hold of one foot, knees together, heel towards our bottom. So for level one, holding the thigh on the floor, but level two, adding more lift. So the thigh bone itself lifts as the hip bone stays down. Breathing into the stretch. And then let's switch and give that a go on the other side. So if we apply some pressure, get that good old stretch down the front of the thigh. Really important for our reducing our risk of falls. Often when these muscles are short and tight, it'll keep us in a forward lean posture throughout our day without us often realizing. So good to work on these, iron them out daily, maintain our independence. So level two, we add some lift through thigh bone. So from here, if you can keep me in the downward dog, lifting our tailbone, wriggling our feet back. So we've got a little bit of a gap under the heels and pressing the heels down. Breathe. And I'm going to wrap one foot just around the back here as we apply a bit more pressure to that side. Lift upwards, push your hips up, You press your heel down. And let's switch that over to the other side. Pressing the heel down, lifting the tailbone. Our feet towards our hands and come and lay down onto our backs and popping our hands just on top of our belly, closing the eyes and just taking a moment to notice how your body's feeling today. How's your body feeling compared to the start of the session? Where do you feel the most comfort in your body? Feeling the breath underneath your hands, I'd like you to take a deeper breath, then a longer exhale. So you keep blowing out, you can't blow out any more air. And do that again, breathe in. And breathe out for as long as you can. As you keep blowing out, we just squeeze your pelvic floor muscles, hold them in, and then relax. Inhaling. And again, a long exhale, squeezing the pelvic floor at the same time as you blow the air out. Just do that one more time. And then from there, if you can just allow your body some rest. Let your attention drift to the sounds around you. As your attention drifts to the more distant sounds around you, allowing your body to relax down more deeply. Attention back into the space as you open your eyes. Just want you to be mindful of what you can see in your peripheral vision. Colours, the shapes, maybe a cobweb. And we're going to roll over to our side. And as we sit with our legs in front, a little stretch for our neck. So if we can pop our head to one side and then gentle pull, breathe, and let's do that on the other side. So gently pulling over to one side, breathe, and let's pop the hands just here at the back of the head. So we're gonna bring the chin down, applying a little bit of pressure there at the back of the neck. Alrighty, let's release. So